Is Missouri's climate affecting the taste testing of wastewater for spikes of COVID-19?
All new at 5, our Missouri Chief Capitol Bureau reporter Emily Manley is live in Jefferson City with how scientists now have to test for another molecule in the samples for more accurate results. Emily?
Well, Shirley, caffeine. It's in your morning coffee, your energy drink, and even that piece of chocolate you ate. But it's also in your wastewater. And with all the recent rain and flooding in the St. Louis area, it's going to be used as an indicator for researchers.
If it rains so hard that it overflows, that's what throws us off.
Some parts of St. Louis saw more than a foot of rain this week, overloading the sewer system.
It significantly dilutes the signal,
making it hard for researchers like Mark Johnson to test wastewater for COVID.
There are other times when we have wondered whether numbers are off, so we switched to a new system where we have our own internal marker to see how dilute the samples have gotten.
That system includes testing for caffeine.
You get caffeine in the sewer shed, the only reason it's there is because people consumed it. You're not going to find it there like in the rivers or anything.
Even when it rains or your street floods, you're probably still drinking the same amount of caffeine.
It's been mostly a research study up until now, but we've started to implement it in places where the wastewater numbers or the what we call the flow rate, which is the total amount of sewer that passed through a sewer shed in a day, if the numbers are unreliable.
Johnson, the lead researcher of the project at Mizzou, says to test for caffeine, it takes a few days.
Just like you can taste your orange juice and tell if it's been diluted, we can measure the caffeine in the wastewater, which will tell us whether the human contributions have been diluted.
Other parts of the state are experiencing a drought. According to the U.S. Drought Monitor, more than 20 counties are in an extreme drought. So what does a lack of rain do to the sewer shed project?
When there's a drought, people still flush as much as they did when there wasn't a drought. So those numbers stay fairly constant.
Now, Johnson says his lab will have the caffeine results from the St. Louis area next week. He also said that since March, there has been a weekly increase in COVID-19 in wastewater samples. According to the state health department, in the past week, there have been nearly 13,000 new cases in the state. Reporting live tonight from Missouri State Capitol Bureau in Jefferson City, I'm Emily Manley, Fox 2 News.